How's it going? So I'm getting ready now to go to my appointment for the fluoroscopy. Pretty much the test today is to test out my tubes to see how they're looking, to see if they're clear, if it's a clear path for my baby to pass, for the eggs to do what they need to do. So I'll be going there this morning, trying to wrap up my little hair here. It's all puffed out, so I gotta calm it down. Nothing special. I plan to do my eyebrows today, by the way, because they're looking rough. Anyway, so I'll be going there here in the next 30 minutes. I'll be heading out there. And I will check in with you guys when I'm done. Again, this is just an HSD fluoroscopy, and doc just wants to see if my tubes are clear. If everything looks good, when I go to the appointment on February the 14th, he'll let me know my results of that and all my blood work that we did as well on my first appointment. My blood work was to check for my insulin levels. To see if my ACE, is it the AC1? I don't remember. I should be on top of that shit, but I forget. To see if my levels are good or if he needs to up my dosage of the metformin, which I'm thinking he's gonna up it to 1,000 milligrams instead of the 500 that I'm taking now. So we'll find out to see what he says. I'm so looking forward to that appointment on February the 14th. But for now, I'm gonna head out to my appointment for the fluoroscopy HSG. I called this morning. They told me to take an ibuprofen before my appointment, and also doc prescribed me some medication to take after the appointment because apparently it is known for women to get an infection after the appointment, either due to the dye of that they put inside you. So I have a 3-day antibiotic to take afterwards. Levaquin, I'm taking the generic of Levaquin. So we'll see. We'll see how it goes. I'll let you know how it feels. Never done this before, so I will let you know my details afterwards. I'll check in with you guys in a little bit. Bye. Hey there, everyone. So I just finished my HSD fluoroscopy, and so it was this machine that they used to take. It's an X-ray. It's just a different type of X-ray that will take a picture of my fallopian tubes. So it's just a real big machine, and it's like getting a pap smear done. You lay down and they put the whole pap smear stuff, and they have to put a catheter, which was very uncomfortable. I think that's where I felt most of the discomfort. And then they have to insert the iodine so that it can go through and they can actually see if my tubes are clear. And so, I didn't really. I started to feel more cramps towards the end of the when he was almost done. I think because of the iodine, that he was inserting created a lot of pressure. It was a discomfort, but we're women. We can take on so much plus more. So much that plus more. So nothing that is unbearable, nothing too scary or anything. So that's that. They're going to send my results to my doctor, which he pretty much told me that my tubes look clear. He showed me how the iodine goes right through the fallopian tubes, my uterus and the fallopian tubes, and everything looks clear. So that's a plus. So they're going to send my results over to Doc, and I will be seeing Doc in 1 week, and we'll see how things go from there. Yay! We're moving forward. I'm so excited. I think this is probably the farthest I've ever gone with all this stuff. It's the first time I ever do this. So I'm excited. So excited. So excited. Just also to let you guys know, my weight loss journey, it began. I started to really nip it probably 2 weeks ago. And then last week, since I was on my period, I didn't go to the gym. I would have gone, but I was bleeding too much. I promise I would have gone. I was bleeding too much. So I didn't go. So I'm back again and going every day. Today's Wednesday. I went Monday. I went Tuesday. And I will be going tonight. And of course, my food intake is completely different. I gave up dinner. The only thing I do eat for dinner, well, it's an early dinner because I get off of work at 7. So I get home too late to eat actual dinner. So I gave up eating food. So I do a protein shake for dinner. And I've been doing that by far for, this is my 3rd week. Because even when I was on my period, I was still eating the way I should be eating. I'm not going to lie, Super Bowl weekend, on Sunday, I ate 2 burgers. Not back to back, but I ate 2 burgers, and it felt pretty damn good. There were some good burgers. So, anyways, well, that was it, guys. Oh, another thing I didn't mention. When you're done with the test, the iodine has to come out. So, they give you a napkin and a pad. And I came with a panty liner. I always typically wear a panty liner, and it was a pretty thick one today. So I was like, I don't need the pad. It felt like I was peeing myself. This is after I wiped myself. Like, I wiped myself like really good, and I guess after I was like, my movement of putting my pants on, it felt like I was like peeing myself. So I was like, oh my god, let me go grab that pad she gave me and put it on, because it was a thicker pad, and it's kind of gross, but it was just the iodine. I wasn't peeing myself, just the iodine, guys. So don't freak out when it's happening. It's just the iodine coming out. And so when I pull my pants back down to put the pad back on, some iodine came out to the floor. That was gross. I felt so bad. I was like, oh my god, how embarrassing. I was gonna go grab a napkin, and the nurse came back, and she's like, all done? I was like, almost. I was like, can I have a napkin? So yeah, just put that pad on. It's a thicker pad. It'll just keep it there. I still had to go to the restroom afterwards, because that's just gross. I felt like I had to just let it out and pee. But just a heads up, in case you guys go and get this fluoroscopy, and it's the HSG to check your tube, to see how everything's looking in there. Just be ready for that if you want to take a little towel or whatever makes you happy. Then you're gonna have to carry a dirty towel, so they give you stuff there, so no worries. All right, guys, well, I will check in with you guys in a week from now. I'm a little backed up on posting my videos because I'm new to all this posting stuff. Oh, I can't wait to get rid of my double chin. I'm new to all this posting video stuff, so I'm still trying to figure out how to edit and stuff. So if I repeat some things and you see duplicates, sorry. I'm still learning. I'm sure I'll get better as I go. Well, I guess I'll let you guys go. I'm gonna be in a little bit of traffic here. There's always traffic in Houston. No matter what time of the day it is, there's always traffic. And it doesn't help that it's rainy and cold. It's not too bad. Kind of died down on the rain. Well, you guys take care, and I will check in with you guys on February 14th when I go see my doctor, my fertility doctor. I'm so excited, guys. I hope everything, I pray everything goes great. Pray for me. I pray for you guys. If anybody is going through this as well, I pray for you guys that everything turns out great. All you can do is, you know, just be, you know, with positive spirits, and you know, whether somebody's supporting you or someone's not, just think of how beautiful it's gonna feel when we're told that we're gonna have a baby. So keep your heads up, don't get discouraged on anything. Let's move forward. I don't know what to expect. It may be good, it may be bad. I don't know what's gonna happen. All I know is that I'm leaving it in God's hands, and I pray that everything turns out amazing. Well, you guys take care, have a blessed day, and I will talk to y'all soon.